Welcome back to some more Umineko When They Cry. So where we last left off, you know. Rosa tried to force this narrate. I want to say, I keep saying this. What the fuck is wrong with me? She's trying to get like everyone to say that Kanon is the culprit. But luckily, Balor did step in. He did prove Kanon's innocence, but he couldn't figure out how Jessica was killed. You know, he took the L. Well, it is what it is. You know, I guess we have to cope for the most part. I did learn, like, two opposing sides. Balor is trying to prevent the other characters from getting pointed from by Rosa, while Rosa is... See, that's the thing. Both Rosa and Balor, I'm pretty sure I already know that both, like, believe that the Beatrice, the witches don't... See, Rosa said earlier that he said witches don't exist, and Balor said that is denying Beatrice exists. So but both have a similar opinion, agree on. However, both have opposing sides and a different method. That Rose is doing this thing, just sacrificing the other, you know, disrespecting the dead and so on and so forth. And Balor is just like, is defending. Mostly just defending them. That's one thing I learned. No. But here's the thing about Rosa. If you're saying that witches don't exist, but you're basically using other characters as a way of like as a part of a culprit. Wouldn't I just say that Rosa is kind of low key working for the witch? Then you're saying witches don't exist, but you're kind of like using Kanon, who is already dead, as a culprit. You're kind of making the witch like heavily amused. Like you're kind of working for. That's kind of my theory. I'm pretty sure I'm going to be, but I'm pretty sure I've said something dumb of a statement, but oh well. Coping. Let's continue. With Jessica's death, it became certain that the culprit was hiding somewhere nearby, that they'd come for our lives if they had a chance. According to Genji-san, when tomorrow morning comes, the boat should arrive. The boat had a radio. We'd probably be able to contact the police directly with that. All of us gathered in the parlor decided to wait quietly until tomorrow. I proposed that we should search throughout the mansion for clues about the culprit, but Aunt Rosa rejected that, saying that if we managed to corner the culprit or maybe provoke them, it might lead to a third murder. That was probably the right thing to do. If a bunch of amateurs like us investigated, there's no way we'd find anything. It would be wisest to focus on protecting ourselves without doing anything unnecessary and leave it to the police starting tomorrow. We'd been tense at the beginning, but other than Aunt Rosa, most of us had spent all morning watching TV and getting bored, so our sense of danger had faded considerably. When we thought about it, yes, six adults certainly had been killed together in the first murder. But that made it seem like some backhanded method like poison had been used. And for the second murder, we figured those two became sacrifices because they'd been unfortunately isolated from the rest of us. From this, it was possible to imagine that the culprit wasn't a large amount of adults, and that they wouldn't be capable of killing this large group gathered in the parlor all at once. Right now in this parlor, there's George, Aniki, and me, Maria, Aunt Rosa, Genji-san, Goda-san, Shaden-san, Kumasawa-san, and then Dr. Nanjo, for a total of 9 people. Furthermore, Aunt Rosa was even armed with a gun. I mean, when she has an angry face with a gun, I would fucking cry. It'd be real though. I'm pretty sure I said something unfair about her, like the past part or two. Still. Surely, with this many people staying in this room, they wouldn't be able to touch us easily. That feeling of security, along with the passage of time, allowed us to recover from the shock of that morning bit by bit. What are we supposed to eat in the parlor? That's the thing. Especially with Rosa being like way more strict than thick. Allowed us to recover from the shock of that morning bit by bit. By the way, lunchtime had just ended for us. However, it had been a canned food lunch, a far cry from the dinner last night that Goda-san had skillfully made for us. And Rosa also suspected that poison may have been used in the first murder, so we probably couldn't deny the possibility that the culprit had snuck into the kitchen during all that confusion in the morning and mixed poison in with the ingredients there. Aunt Rosa gave orders to all of us saying that, until the police came, we mustn't put anything into our mouths except safe things like canned food. As a cook, Goda-san must have felt very let down. Apparently eager to display his skill anyway, he said he at least wanted to grab some plates and arrange the canned food on them. At first, Aunt Rosa had been reluctant, examining each one of the plates that was brought, but she hadn't been able to find anything to complain about, and Goda's chef's pick canned food lunch combo was born. Goda-san said something about taste being savored, not just with the tongue, but with the eyes as well. I see. It's the same canned food we ate for breakfast, but it feels like something completely different. What's completely different? And that's the thing. That's what I'm trying to ask.
Mite, mite! Kore ga ookami to hitsuji no puzzle.
The wolves and sheep puzzle. Is the wolves and sheep have anything to do with the metaphor? As I was sitting lazily on the sofa with no desire to watch the TV, Maria came over, pulled a picture book out of her handbag and held it out
to me.
You know, speaking of the wolves and sheep, I always thought the witch is the wolf. Wouldn't Rosa also be the wolf too, and then we're just the sheep? I don't know, man. Like, what Rosa was doing, she was trying to, like, put that suspicion on a certain other.
Okami to hitsuji no puzzle?
Wolves and sheep puzzle.
Dore dore?
Wolves and sheep puzzle. It was a phrase that Aunt Rosa had said this morning when we'd gone to call on Jessica. At the time, I hadn't known what it meant, and right after that was that uproar when Jessica's corpse was found, so I'd forgotten about it completely. The book that Maria held out to me looked like a foreign picture book or something that had been translated. When I opened it, I realized that it was a book stuffed with riddles. I didn't even know there's few wolves. I thought there's like one wolf. But it's been so long. I'm pretty sure growing up as little kids, we picked your books at the time. How am I supposed to know this shit?
そんなルールのゲームを聞いたことあるな。これはそれの狼と羊バージョンなのか。
It was a very simple puzzle, passed on from long ago. Let's try posing a question. On the right there, there are two wolves, two sheep. There's a boat that as many as two animals can ride on, and using it, you have to move all four of them to the opposite left bank. That's the puzzle. There are two wolves. Wait.Is this what the reader needs to do, is try to understand the fucking puzzle in this game? Oh my god. I can't believe they inserted a puzzle game in the fucking, in a read-through. Oh man. Okay, there are two rules. The first is regarding the boat. Even a single wolf or a single sheep can paddle it. But it can only hold two animals.The second rule is regarding the wolves. When they are greater in number than the sheep in any location, they attack the sheep and it's game over. For example, at the start of the game, let's say the two sheep get in the boat and go to the other side. Then one sheep gets off and the other goes back to the first bank. Okay.The first bank. When it does, there are two wolves on the first bank, and a single sheep returns there. When that happens, the number of wolves is greater, so the sheep is attacked, and is game over. Game over. So, number of wolves is greater than the sheep, and the sheep is attacked.On either bank, or even the boat, there must never be more wolves than sheep. And you've got to shuttle them all across under these conditions. By the way, the right answer is to move both wolves to the opposite bank in the first turn. Then one wolf comes back.On the second turn, you move two sheep to the opposite bank. Then one wolf comes back. Then on the third turn, you put that last wolf that was on the right bank on the boat and cross to the opposite bank. And congratulations, transport successful. Is this like one of the simple math where you have to have like an even amount of sheep and an even amount of wolves on that certain boat type of thing?Ain't this a partway? There may be the same number of wolves and sheep in the boat or on either side, but that isn't a problem. You only lose when the number of wolves is greater. This book uses wolves and sheep as an example, but lots of people probably know of this game using different characters. It looked like Maria wanted to test whether I too could solve the puzzle she knew how to solve, and she kept showing me different pages, saying,Solve this one, and this one's hard. So, what was happening when Aunt Rosa first mentioned this puzzle? That's right. When we decided to go and get Jessica, we talked about how many men could go, and Aunt Rosa mentioned the wolves and sheep puzzle, saying we should all go together.
Oi, oi.
That could only mean one thing. Aunt Rosa was saying that there was a wolf among us. So was she thinking that we'd be safe if the number of wolves and sheep was in balance, but that the wolves could bear their fangs if the situation changed? At the time we found our parents' corpses, Aunt Rosa already suspected that the servants might be wolves. She'd sniffed out the possibility that,While she didn't know whether it was all of them or some of them, there were wolves hiding among them. That's no surprise. That murder scene was very elaborate. It's easy to imagine that there were multiple culprits. And because she reached that conclusion, when we went to Jessica's room and learned that Jessica had been killed after being alone with the servant, Hannah, it isn't hard to imagine why Aunt Rosa suspected her servant so persistently.
使用人の皆さん、郷田さんが食器を洗いに厨房に戻ります。念のためです。皆さんも同行してください。皆さん、申し訳ありません。団体行動で参りましょう。What
can go wrong?
社の熊沢、行くぞ。
はいはい、ただいま。それではジョージさん、一度失礼いたします。うん、気をつけて。あ、ローザおばさん、僕も一緒に行っていいかな。ごめんなさい、ジョージ君は残ってくれるかしら。
Unfortunate.
ちょっとお話ししたいことがあるの。そうですか。シャノン、ごめん。とにかく気をつけて。一人にならないでね。はい。南條先生、すみません。
ちょっとご相談が。はい、何ですかな。
No words. The servants put the dishes and empty cans on the serving cart and started to head out into the corridor. Behind them, Aunt Rosa was talking to Dr. Nanjo about something in a small voice.
わかりました。
What did she say to him? Dr. Nanjo closed the book he had been reading, rose from the sofa, followed after the servants. Aunt Rosa stuck her head out into the hallway. After seeing that they were completely out of sight, he closed the door and spoke. Oh boy.
みんな聞いて。これで今ここにいるのは後宮の人間だけね。うん。確かにそうなりますね。狼を全部追い出したってことっすか、ローザおばさん。That
is true. If she keeps pointing her finger at every servant that is available and alive, then that means that they're wolves. That is a statement, right? That is true. With that one sentence, Aunt Rosa's gaze grew sharp. Apparently, she had picked up on the sarcasm. He laughed lightly.
バトラ君は頭の回転が早いのね。賢い子は好きよ。話が早いわ。おお、バトラ頭いい？64ページの難しいの。
マリアは少しの間テレビを見ていなさい。ママはバトラ君たちとお話があるの。おお。ローザおばさん、パズルの話はバトラ君に聞いたよ。用心深いのは悪いことじゃないと思うけど、
さすがに疑り深すぎるのもどうかと思うよ。
真の犯人がベアトリーチェかどうかは別にして、少なくとも使用人たちがその一味であることを疑うことはできると思うの。
I mean, I guess the servants know about Beatrice, so I guess that's kind of the... Maybe I kind of sort... Maybe... I sort of kind of... I sort of understood why Rosa is like that. Look, man, I... That's not me being flabbergasted on purpose. Rosa is getting me flabbergasted.
兄さんたちが殺されていた最初の殺人。とても残酷な仕打ちがされていたわよね。
You can say they were brutally murdered, that's
for... あれが一人でできる真似に見える。
謎の来客。ベアトリーチェ様が夜鍋をしてチクチクやったのかもしれねえぜ。
ジェシカちゃんの部屋の扉をめぐるマスターキンの件は使用人の誰かが関わっている証拠じゃない。
No word. Only the master key could have locked the door to Jessica's room, so we can only suppose that one of the servants did it.No, wait.
チェス盤をひっくり返すぜ。おかしいよ、ローザおばさん。なんで犯人はジェシカを殺した後、わざわざ施錠したんだ？施錠すれば、マスターキーの持ち主が疑われるのは必然。わざわざ施錠する必要がないぜ。
そうだよ。バトラ君の言う通りだ。わざわざ疑われるようなことをする理由がない。
うん。それは面白い考えよね。もちろん、私もそれは考えた。だとしたら、施錠した人物は使用人を疑わせたくて。マスターキーなしであの扉を閉めた。でもそれは不可能。でしょ？
That's right. If there existed some trick that could lock that door without a master key, that would make this a great disguise for casting doubt on the servant.If the culprit's goal was for us to isolate ourselves from the group so they could attack us one by one, this trick would also be effective at giving rise to paranoia. But there was no way to lock that door without using a master key.
マスターキーを使わずに閉める方法がない。なんて、どうして言い切れるの？ルドルフ兄さんの言っていた悪魔の証明になるんじゃない？私たちには想像もつかない方法で閉められたのかもしれない。
Locked by some method we can't think of. Like... Well... If it's not a key... Would you... Maybe you can like... Lock the door with like some kind of... I mean...Not like a lockpick. I mean, lockpicks are used to open locked doors. Or you can pick lock it. Pick the lock. But surely they have like some sort of tool to like reverse that, right? I don't know.
私たちに思いつかないからといって未知のトリックがあることを否定することにはならない。
そりゃそうだけどよ。つまりあれか？疑わしきは黒ってわけなのか？
具体的なトリックはわからないけれど、 それでも外角はわかるの。
What's the general idea?
申し訳ないけど、カノン君を犯人だと仮定すると、非常に簡単に説明できる。死体がない理由までね。
We're just gonna go back to that argument again.
え？だって、カノン君はマスターキーを持ってなかったんですよ。他の使用人ならともかく、カノン君にだけは施錠はできなかったはず。
なるほど。それでローザおばさんは、ジェシカの部屋に入って早々に、俺たちにクローゼットなんかを探せと言い出したわけか。ローザおばさんこそ、普段の様子から想像できるより、頭の回転が早いな。
Either her mind works fast, or that's just how he panics. Maybe she's just... What if she's just panicked? Nah, there's no way.
妹の頭の回転速度は常に姉マイナス1よ。
The brain speed of a little sister is always the big sister's minus 1. Okay.
今は誰にも気を使う必要がないからせいせいするわ。
What do you mean there's no one you need to worry about offending? George Aniki realized she was referring to Aunt Eva. Oh. George Aniki realized she was referring to Aunt Eva and seemed a little uncertain about how he could take that sarcasm.
ごめん。僕にも分かるように説明してほしいな。カノン君のマスターキーはジェシカちゃんのポケットに入って密室に閉じ込められていた。
Wait. He was referring to Aunt Eva. Is Rosa being snide about Eva? All because like Aunt...Eva usually makes fun of Rosa. Maybe that's kind of why. Because Eva being the older sister, and that Rosa doesn't like it how it like, gets like, you know, fun of, you know.
Go, man.
Oops. Misclick.Canon-kun's master key was in Jessica Chan's pocket, closed up inside a closed room.
施錠した後に、部屋の外からポケットに入れるなんて芸当は不可能なはず。
After the door was locked, it should have been impossible to put it in her pocket from an outside room, no matter what the trick was.
違うんだよ、兄貴。
His body disappeared. He can freaking, like...Erased out of existence, but can't really check his pocket. Then.
ローザおばさんの想像しているやり方なら、このトリックはカノン君にしか使えない。
This trick could only be used by Canon.
そして、ジェシカのポケットにマスターキーを入れたまま、鍵なしで施錠することができる。そして、その結果として、死体もなくなることになる。
どうやって鍵なしでどうやって施錠するんだい。
簡単よ。ジョージ君だって帰宅したら施錠するでしょ。つまみをひねってカチリとね。
まさか、いや、でも、カノン君の姿はどこにも。
兄貴にもピンと来たみてえだな。ローザおばさんが室内を探したのはそういうことだ。内側から鍵を閉め、ジェシカのポケットに鍵を突っ込んだカノン君が、
You can lock the door from the inside with just a button. I guess that is true. Stuck the key in Jessica's pocket.
どこかに隠れて、俺たちをやり過ごそうとしているのを探したんだ。
It was the simplest kind of closed room trick. It meant him hiding inside the closed room after the murder was committed. Then all he had to do was get out after those who discovered the body left, and the closed room would work perfectly.
私たちはあの部屋を探したけれど、何も見つけられなかった。
That would be... wait, what? He was like...They didn't find where the body is. Wait. That's strange. They were in the middle of arguing. The culprit would have snuck out like that. Bro, what? Didn't find anything.
でも、だからといって、あの部屋に使用人たちしか知らない秘密の隠し通路のようなものがないとは言えない。
What is there like a secret path? What, there's like a seal? What, does her room have like a bookshelf and you pull some, this one little thing in the show where you pull a certain book out and there's a secret passage? Is that what you're trying to say from here? Because I've seen a lot, because trust me, I've seen a lot, I've watched shows and I play video games where they've done shit like this, but I'm,And you know what? It would be dope if I would have a secret passage where I just open from just pulling a certain thing out.
それがどこに隠されていたかはわからないけれど、その隠し通路を仮定し推理することで彼しかありえないと断言できるのよ。
Now that's just wild.
その推理はよ、俺も一番最初に考えた。一番嫌な推理だから、一番最初にその可能性を潰したかった。
Oh boy, here we go with this.
カノンはこの部屋で殺された。であろう?
It is, yeah, he was killed in that room.
そなたはカノンが犯人であると疑いそうになったため、真っ先にその可能性を潰すために、これを復唱させたのだ。わかっておる、わかっておる。
Would be kind of odd that someone is taking the role of Canon. Made this sort of thing where they just kill out Jessica like that. What? And just fake his death. Oh shit. I'm just falling for some troll bait right here.
だから、その次に考えたのはこうだった。あの部屋にいたのは実は3人だったという説だ。ジェシカとカノン君は被害者。そして、犯人である来客ベアトリーチェも一緒にいた、という考えだ。
そなたは、人間であるわらわが、魔法を使わずに犯行を行ったことにしたいのだったな。
Be human, Beatrice.
なるほど。そなたにぴったりの親切であるぞ。
Wouldn't be surprising if the quote-unquote human Beatrice had like some sort of a gun hidden in her jacket. You see? She agrees with me. Oh. I gotta say, Beatrice got some decent laughs. Her laughs show that this game is goofy. Is all that matters.
お前は二人を殺し、内側から施錠した。そして、カノン君の死体を担いで、普通の人は気づかない秘密の方法。つまり、隠し扉を使って部屋から脱出したんだと読んだ。しかし、お前に赤で言われちまった。あの部屋に隠し扉の類はないってな。
He did say that, yeah.
うん。お前たちの知らない秘密の通路は存在せぬぞ。ノックスだったかバンダインだったか。
ノックス、バンダイン。Now these are two. Now these are the two that I'm really unheard of.
何でもミステリーには秘密の通路があってはいけないらしい。
Is Knox and Van Dyne are the ones that I assume that their authors of mystery novel? I don't really delve as much into mystery stuff.
そのお作法にわらわも従ったということよ。つまり名探偵は部屋を調べ尽くさずして隠し通路がないと断言できるわけだ。人間の推理ごっことはなんとお気楽なものよの。
クソ、でけえこと言いやがるぜ。ありがとうよ、魔女様のお取り計らいのおかげで俺も部屋を探し尽くさずに、あの部屋に隠し扉がないと断言できるぜ。
うん。この部屋に隠し扉はない。
Yes, you said this to me already.
扉と窓以外に出入りする方法はない。
There's no way to get in or out other than the door and the way you just said that you said the windows part.
てことはよ。今、ローザおばさんがぶってる自信満々の仮説は間違ってるってわけだ。しかも悔しいことに、この仮説は反証不能だ。魔女のお前は赤で、隠し扉はないと断言すれば、それで決着する。しかし人間の俺は、ローザおばさんにそれを反論しても受け入れられないだろう。隠し扉がないことを人間は証明できない。
Humans can't prove there's no hidden door.
悪魔の証明になっちまう。くそ。魔女ってのは便利だな。そんな、あるかないかもわからない隠し扉を理由にカノン君を犯人呼ばわりするなんて、僕は納得できないな。
納得できないならより納得できる推理を聞かせて。ないのよ。私はずっと考えてる。これしかないのよ。
The way Rosa talks sounds very similar to what a yes man would do to Beatrice or the witch or, you know, whichever that associates with. with the witch. I get. What the heck?
George-kun wa Shannon-chan to naga ga yokatta wa ne. Dakara, shiyou-nin zenyin ga hannin de aru koto wa ukeire gatai to omou no. Watashi mo Shannon-chan ga hannin no ichimi de aru nante shinjitaku nai. Demo, zenyin de aru ka inaka wa tomokaku, kakujitsu ni ano naka ni hannin, moshiku wa kyouhan ga iru no yo. それだけは見誤っちゃダメ。
カノン君以外にも狼がいると見てたんだな。ジェシカの部屋で犯人はカノン君だと大騒ぎしたのは使用人たちの反応を見るためだったっていうのか。
Giving them the reaction you wanted.
ええ、そうよ。そしてその結果、私は一層の疑いを持つに至ったわ。確実に使用人の中に狼がいる。
I mean, most of the servants know about Beatrice, so
確実にね。
I guess I can't. So I guess, you know, because they know about Beatrice, they are the wolves, huh?
そして、狼と羊のパズルのように、普段はおとなしくしているけれど、チャンスがあったら襲ってくるに違いないの。ジェシカちゃんは一人で船に乗った羊よ。あのパズルでは頭数の時は襲ってこないけど、私たちのパズルは違う。チャンスと人数次第なら頭数でも襲ってくる。ジェシカちゃんが殺されたように。
僕は怒りたいことがある。じゃあ厨房へ行かされてるシャノンは危険な状態じゃないか。今すぐ僕たちも厨房へ行くべきだ。誰が狼だろうと狼でなかろうと、僕たち全員が揃っていれば均衡するならそれを保ち続けるべきだと思う。
シャノンちゃんはお父様のところへゲンジさんと一緒に行った。その時に孤立したはずなのに殺されなかった。ゲンジさんも狼ではないから。違うわ、二人とも狼だったからよ。
シャノンは悪事の片棒を担ぐような人じゃない。いくらローザおばさんでもそれは聞き流せません。今の発言に対し僕は取り消しを要求します。
Defending her just like that, huh?
兄貴の前で悪いが、その論法エヴァおばさんの雰囲気にそっくりだな。こっちが反論できなきゃ自動的に自分が正しいみたいな。
I'm the thing of it. Maybe Rosa gaining ego, she's probably gaining that ego from Eva.
やっぱり血は争えないな、おばさん。
私だって今の自分はあまり褒められたものじゃないとは思ってる。でもね、私は母なの。マリアの無事を守るためなら鬼にもなるわ。本当ならマリアと二人きりでどこかに閉じこもっていたいくらいよ。
You've become even a demon to protect Maria's safety. Well, at least. So I guess I did kind of say something that she's kind of, the demon is possessing Rosa to protect her. Okay. What if?
Demo. 私は同時にあなたたちの母でもあるつもりなの。今やあなたたちは私の子供も同然。私は自分の子じゃないからといってあなたたちを見捨てたりしない。絶対。
そりゃどうも。
私はあなたたちの母として油断しないでと警告したかっただけなの。常に私の目の届くところにいて。
Stay where I can see you at all times.
私があなたたちを守ってあげる。
Part of me thinks she's doing this for her own sake because she cares about Badler and the other kids, like, well, George is an adult, and, I mean, what do we have of maybe, excluding is there, George, Battler, Jessica, oh, wait, Jessica's already dead, I'm stupid, George, Battler, Maria, you know, excluding all the servants, I don't know about Nanja, but I guess I could assume Rosa could, like, insert a doctor with the servants, I guess. Rosa is a bit fucked in the head. I don't want to be this far, but is she a little crazy? Crazy over. I guess overly protective could be a safe way to describe her.
ついでに、俺たちが狼でないことも監視してくれるってわけだ。そりゃありがたいぜ。そういうおばさんは、自分が狼ではないって証明はできるのかよ。
Oh, shit.What did Aunt Rosa do? I mean, I did kind of made a theory about Rosa. I'm pretty sure I said that earlier, but...
Hey, できるわ。
What, you can?
即答っすね。
Yeah, this is... What is wrong with her?
どうやって?
That's the same question I'm trying to ask.
これよ。
This?
これが証拠よ。
Aunt Rosa lifted her gun and pointed the barrel at them. But it was only for an instant. She immediately lowered the gun, laughing impishly. Impishly. But to me, the time I spent staring down the barrel of that gun...Felt like an eternity.
その銃がどうローザおばさんが犯人でないことを証明するというんですか。
Just because your firearm isn't the proof that you aren't a wolf doesn't mean you're guaranteed innocent. Like.Anyone can be afford the power of the gun. Like, I'm pretty sure anyone can, like, you know, can raise some suspicion there.
考えてもみて。私が犯人だったらどう?使用人たちが出ていたこの千載一遇の機会を逃すと思う?あなたたちをズドンと撃って。あとは適当な言い訳をするだけよ。窓の外にベアトリーチェが現れて銃を撃ってきたとかね。私は2発を撃ち返したと称して 2発分の空薬莢を床に捨てればいい。
そりゃすげえ乱暴な理論だが、確かに一理あるぜ。
He argues with violence. I guess that's one way to put it.
クラウス兄さんが昔よく言ってたわ。力こそ正義ってね。これがまさにそうなのかしら。ごめんなさいね、二人とも。私も今朝からの事件続きでかなり冷静さを失ってる。普段の私を知る二人から見れば、今の私は余裕がなくて少し短気そうに見えるかもしれない。
Well, like I said, at least you're being self-aware.
でも分かってる。
I guess Rosa, you know, beating up Maria is one way to show that he's easily short-tempered.
私は悪意ある犯人からあなたたちを守りたい。そのためには鬼になる。
What?
それだけのことなの。怒らせるようなことを言ってごめんなさいね。バトラ君、ジョージ君、仲直りしましょう。
An unsatisfied expression rose to George Aniki's face. He probably couldn't forgive the damage done to Shannon's honor. What about me? Several bits of circumstantial evidence hinted at the servant's participation. I didn't want to believe that one of them was the culprit or possibly colluding with the culprit, but in our current situation, that was little more than wishful thinking.Whom should I believe? In the first place, who is the culprit? Are there accomplices? And if so, how many? It seems I've only been suspecting... It seems I've only been suspecting the people we know. I quickly forgot that 19th person. The guest, Beatrice, who arrived yesterday and boldly claimed to be the Golden Witch. In fact, I still haven't seen her face.I heard she greatly resembled the witch in that portrait, but since I haven't seen her directly, no matter how hard I try, it doesn't really feel to me like a 19th person is on this island. So I've been subconsciously hallucinating that the culprit wanted the 18th. Damn it. Come out, Beatrice.If you're the bad guy, then act like the bad guy and show yourself, laughing in a high-pitched voice and mocking it. Just like a bad guy in one of those dramas who, even when they're exposed as the culprit, aggressively says, Where's your proof? Well,And there she says it.
うっせえ。てめえはしばらく黙ってろ。
He just told Beatrice to shut the fuck up. that was funny. Alright. That was a good part to end it from here.Alright. Next part. Let's see what they say on the servant's perspective. On the servant's end, right there. So, like, comment, subscribe. I will see you guys later. Have a good one.